Hello friends, this is the third lecture for the analysis of a simple truss, where we'll be seeing the components of a roof truss as shown in the figure. You can just take a screenshot of the truss as shown over here. I've shown the labeling of different types of parts of the truss, or we can say component of a roof truss. So this is the roof. This dark blue colored is roof. So it is the boundary of a roof, where I have labeled everything with this orange sketch pen, and dimensions are given with this skin colored sketch pen. So this becomes the span of the roof truss, and this becomes the spacing of the roof truss, how long this spacing is. So this roof truss is supported on the wall, we can say, as shown in this brown colored sketch pen. The load is transferred towards the through the wall to the foundation. So now we understood the role of the wall. Why is it here? Then the next thing is, this is the roof covering, brown colored. This is actually on this entire span, but here it is shown because we can see through the roof and we can analyze the truss, or we can say we can observe the truss. So the line connecting this spacing of the roof truss from here apex to this apex is known as ridge, where this apex point at both the side is known as ridge point. And this diagonal line connecting this end to the apex is known as principal rafter. This one, this one, this one, and this one. This means it has four principal rafters. Then after, these are the members of the truss, where this vertical one is sag die, and the distance of this apex till here is rise. It is written over here, rise, R-I-S-E. Then this base will become main tie, M-A-I-N, main tie. And then comes this dotted lines, which resembles the continuation of this truss over the entire span, which is known as purlin, P-U-R-L-I-N, purlin. So the distance between these two dotted lines means distance between two purlins. So this is given spacing of purlins. So this becomes some of the terminology regarding the truss, which we need to remember. And this sketch should be in our mind while talking about the truss. So that was all for our third lecture. We'll terminate over here. And in fourth lecture, we'll continue with internal resistance forces in the members. And we'll go with the flow. So till that time, do like and subscribe my videos.